Back at Dakota Arena for the U11 finals in the SDP Invitational. Minnesota in the white, Lake Effect Elite in the dark. And we are underway. Wesley Grossman on the left playing out to center ice for Minnesota. And now it winds up loose to the blue line and finally played into the Lake Effect zone. Patrick Anderson, 24, onto the far side. Minnesota holding on the wall. And now they do come out. And a pass and a near breakaway comes on to the Minnesota goaltender Renner Anderson, 31, as Robbie So tried to sneak through. Kind of wearing the Michigan-like helmet. Now over the line. Played back by Alex Denny for Lake Effect, and it comes to the red line, finally played on in. Winds up behind the goal where Zach Martin will take over for it. For Minnesota, now gets some help from Luca Machi, number 5, who scored a goal, and these teams met in pool play. The first game these teams played each other, Minnesota winning it 4-1. And quite a scene atop the standings in the U11 round robin. Three teams right up there. Now broken up at the Minnesota blue line. Colton Nash trying to play it out, and now he drops it back in his zone to the near side for Rylan Schneider, 23. Tipped on into the zone. And Lake Effect will pick it up. 14-minute periods again, as we've mentioned. And a 5-goal running time rule in this game. Now stepping through the middle is Stephen Beldy, 43. Gets to the slot area, finally plays it off to the left for Nash, who dumps it behind the net. Now comes around on the near side. And finally Nash again pursued there by 72, Nicholas Best. Winds up running on the dasher boards down behind the net. Ezekiel Perju, 79. Trying to play it ahead. Still loose to the half wall. Minnesota turns it back through Nash, takes the shot, and a save made by Gavin Carroll in goal for Lake Effect, number 30. Renner Anderson wearing 31, as I mentioned, in goal for Minnesota. Minnesota, Miro, and Lake Effect. 5-0, 4-1, 4-1, respectively. There's a shot and a blocker pad save by Carroll off Logan Schlegel. And now picked up and played to the blue line. Schlegel tries to pinch, does, but has men trapped. It's loose at neutral ice now. And finally played ahead. And here's Machi will close over the line. Nice stick handling move. Top of the circle, takes a shot, deflected over the top. Jackson Kleinbrook for Minnesota, number 10, puts it up the slot. Machi has it there, takes a shot, and it's off the defense. And Minnesota able to turn it down low. And they will go after it to the near side. And finally play back behind the net. Austin Bedoy, number 11. Now out to center, turned back by Machi. And now Minnesota back in over the line. Easton Hema, 91. And that winds up in the corner. Kleinbrook going after it for Minnesota, but it's cleared around on the near side. Holden Bogard, who had the goal for Lake Effect when these teams met the first time, plays it ahead. And it comes back into the Minnesota zone. Joseph Costa behind the goal. Plays the far side. Now a rink-wide pass is picked up by Grossman. It'll carry over the line. Grossman goes down and lost the puck, but now goes back to the corner and follows it. Now winds up at the point area, and So plays it out for Lake Effect. Minnesota holding possession there as that's Breland. Is that Breland Tuzno? No, it's 23. It's Schneider instead playing it to center. And now Minnesota will carry over the line. And that is Stinson. Will Stinson puts it down behind the goal. Going after it there is Braden Dean. Centering pass deflected before it can get to the slot. And it comes back into the Minnesota zone. And Martin will come back for it. Martin retreats to the left corner. Played the first 4 minutes of this period. And Grossman, rink-wide pass to center ice, and now Minnesota starts back. They'll play it in. Now back behind the goal, Arnold Schaum for Lake Effect. Now Dean leans on a player against the boards. Right at the hash mark, and now it comes on out to center, and it's controlled there by Schneider. Dances around a man, closes. Schneider works in, takes a shot, and it was deflected by Best at the last moment. Not much on it. And now played off the glass and finally out to center ice. And Grossman trying to play it in, does, but can't hold it there. Now on the turn, Perju causes some trouble. Now finally picked up by Lake Effect, and they clear into the Minnesota zone. It'll come right onto the goaltender, and they'll get a stoppage as So comes in. But Anderson was there to put the glove on it and make the stop. Beldy behind the goal for Minnesota plays it across, and now they come out with 9 minutes to go in the opening period. And now here's a shot by Nash that goes off of Carroll. Goes off his glove and comes back out to center. Now Schlegel chasing back for it for Minnesota, getting some pressure. Feeds over to Nash on the near side. Now a loose puck carried on by Beldy over the line. And we get a whistle, and it's offside with 8:44 to go in the first period. Three shots in the game, all for Minnesota. And a faceoff coming at neutral ice. Minnesota undefeated in this tournament. They allowed only 5 goals in the 5 games. Now played back into the Lake Effect zone. Nash closes the play to the wall, and it's stolen away there. And that's Schneider trying to center. It does save. Rebound chance. Loose, and they score. Minnesota taking advantage of Lake Effect being unable to clear their lines. And that is Perju. Finally, I believe, got the last touch on it for Minnesota after 5 minutes and 33 seconds. So we'll wait on the assists. And Minnesota has a 1-0 lead. Now loose in front, finally runs through to the far side, and Machi will go back for it in the corner, played to the right point. Let's get the goal. So Braylon Tuzno is being given the second assist on that goal. Nash also assisting at 5:33 on the goal by Perju. And now Lake Effect plays it back in, and they will take it behind the goal. Conrad Ciavellis, 27, and we have a penalty coming on Minnesota as it comes in front, and Kleinbrook, I think, is going to take the penalty here. It's going to be either a body check or a rough. And it is, in fact, Jackson Kleinbrook. And the faceoff will come to the left of the Minnesota goal. First power play of the game. Lake Effect gets it. And they trail 1-0. Cham feeds the circle. From the faceoff comes to the circle, and finally picked up by Beldy and cleared. Here's a race for it. And Easton Hema trying to track onto it, but he's just beaten to the puck by Nico Marinarczyk. And now down the near wing comes Lake Effect. Roughing is the penalty. And now it comes loose in front and finally picked up by the defense and cleared. Lake Effect has to come back for it. And here's Alex Denny, number 8, first 30 seconds gone on the power play. Denny over the blue line. Leaves a pass, and here is Marinarczyk with it. He throws it towards the net. Toe saved by Anderson, hugging the post, and the rebound picked up. Schlegel plays it, and now it is cleared, and it winds up getting out to center ice. Marinarczyk going back for it. And now feeds the left, and here they come. Over the line, this is Alex Denny. He goes behind the net. Marinarczyk cuts for the slot. Comes to the right point. Loose right on the line, and Best able to hold it. Now a shot and a blocker save by Anderson. 40 seconds to go. Comes up the slot, and Best's effort is blocked off to the boards. Denny picks it up. Loose along the wall. So centers, and it's going to be picked up there and cleared but not out. Now a shot and a save made by Anderson. Puck lying loose in front as Finn Helminen with a good chance from the left point. The puck cleared back out, and Helminen has it on the turn. 18 seconds in the power play, and over the line they come. Alex Denny to the right. Here's a chance in front, and it dribbles off the stick at the moment of truth for So. And now Minnesota picks it up, and they'll carry down the wing. And from the red line, we'll play it on into the zone. Going after it there is Stinson in the corner with 1 second to go in the penalty. It's over, and Minnesota's at full strength and in possession. Here's Schlegel playing it, and he goes down the wall. It winds up behind the net for Helminen, who has it at the far side. Helminen now puts it in front of his own goal. It's bouncing there, and finally controlled by Lachlan McGuire off to the far boards, and he will flip one into his bench by mistake, and we'll get a faceoff with 5:13. To go in the opening period. 1-0 Minnesota. The goal from Perju, as we mentioned, from Nash and Tuzno. And we've got an equipment issue here with Renner Anderson, who's back at the bench. With the skate as it attaches to his right pad. That's all fixed, and we'll go back for a faceoff. Minnesota in control. Machi plays it down the wall. Backhanded by Best behind the net. Controlled there by Helminen. Drives the near side. Minnesota able to deny for the moment, but finally it comes back into their zone, and Dean over to the far side. Minnesota back in over the line. And a return pass there for Braden Dean. Now loose in front and poked away to the near side. Lake Effect back. And it's controlled there by Steve Dennison. He's over the line. Plays it back behind the goal. Machi will get there first. Steps around one, steers it to the boards. Stinson carries on, and he's got Grossman on the right. Comes over the line, and now peels back. Stinson threw it in front, and now eventually Grossman's going to get onto it behind the net. Looking to center it, and couldn't get it to Dean. Now it comes over to the near side, and Dean hustling over there to make the play. 4:13 to go in the first, and Lake Effect clears to center ice. And over the line, this is Bogart. Bogart steers his way past Tuzno and then falls. Gets back up, feeds the right point. And now down the wall. Goes too far for Bogart, and it winds up behind as McGuire comes in for Lake Effect. And a good win there by McGuire. Centers it. Ooh, and hop the stick of Sham high in the slot. Here's a shot and a glove catch by Renner Anderson. We'll get a faceoff with 3:43 left in the first period, as Austin Bedoin from the top of the left circle, as the goalie looked at it, is able to make the stop. Zuma Morgan on for the faceoff for Lake Effect. Won the draw, and Sham now lost possession, and here comes Minnesota down the wing. It's Nash shooting, rising shot, and a save made by Carroll. Knocked it into the netting. A quick counter strike there by Minnesota, and Colton Nash tried to go top corner with it. Faceoff coming up. And now played behind the net. And that's Perju trying to center it again. And that came to naught. Now Perju steals. Tuzno up the slot. Plays it down low for Nash. And could not get a shot away. Nash back in front. Tuzno spins and shoots and missed wide to the far side. Now controlled by Savelis, and he plays it ahead. Winds up going back behind the net. Marinarczyk going into the corner and throws it ahead. It's going to come rink wide back into the Minnesota zone to the left. and that's Schneider going there for it. Good move by Schneider. He's got some stick skill. His comes down the near wing, and Easton Hema over the line takes the shot. Save made. Rebound is smothered by Carroll for a faceoff. 2:39 left now in the first. Shots are 8-3 Minnesota. And Lake Effect has had the only power play in this game. Now, loose in the near corner. Centering pass winds up trickling through as Costa snuck in there looking for a goal at the back edge. Now played back to the Minnesota blue line. And finally played on in. After it there is Bedoin for Lake Effect. Around on the far side, that's going to be held there by Kleinbrook for Minnesota in front. And a chance, oh, a giveaway and a goal for Minnesota. Couldn't quite get the line cleared, excuse me, and it is Costa sneaking in to score the goal to make it 2-0. Time of that goal is 11 minutes and 57 seconds. Two nothing Minnesota. Now played back into the Lake Effect zone. 1:54 to go. Now comes in front again. Hema and Beldy getting assists on the goal. Minnesota coming close again as it's loose at the left edge. A shot by Stinson is stopped by Carroll. The goal is Costa from Hema and Beldy at 11:57 of the opening period. Now behind the net, Minnesota buzzing again. And Stinson backhands it towards the front of the net. Now loose along the wall. And finally play it on out to center where Minnesota controls with Martin. Gets past one over the line. Still in possession. Martin puts on the brakes, leaves a drop pass to the circle. Centering pass. My goodness. Was that play at a high level as Stinson now feeds it to Machi in the slot. He shoots. Missed the net wide to the near side. Not by a whole lot. Minnesota really putting on pressure now as it goes behind the net. And now Sham knocks a player down, and here comes Lake Effect back to the near side. And out to center, Stinson tips a pass ahead as Lake Effect's Fowler now heading off on a line change. And here they come down the wing. That's Savellis playing it ahead. Finally back into the Lake Effect end with 30 seconds to go in the first period. Minnesota with an 11-3 shot advantage and a 2-0 lead. Picked up and played to the far side and poked back with men trapped, so Minnesota has to clear the zone. They do, and it comes out to center. Bouncing puck there, and Bogart plays it in. Machi will pick it up for Minnesota with 10 seconds to go, and then reverses up the wall, controlled there by Morgan for Lake Effect, and he can't do anything with it. Comes to the point and poked out to center as the first period comes to an end, and Minnesota takes a 2-0 lead to intermission after one. So we'll take a quick break and come back with our second period next. This is the SDP Invitational on the Youth Hockey Hub.
In life, we all need a little help to reach our summit. Whatever your summit looks like, it's easier to reach when your body is strong and healthy. At Summit Orthopedics, our team of highly specialized physicians listens to and values every one of our patients. We take a conservative approach to care to get you back to your healthy and active lifestyle. Reach your summit. Summit Orthopedics. Visit summitortho.com to make an appointment today.
Group of Lots and Lots of Pizza encourages the community pickup hockey game, honors the family that builds the neighborhood-known backyard rink, salutes the passion utilizing a frozen lake to play a game that's loved, endorses the stardom early mindset to build contenders, acknowledges the grit, determination, and competition of the sport, and applauds the coach that demands the before the sun comes up outdoor practice. Brewpub Lots of Matzah Pizza supports hockey anytime, anywhere.
Second period from Dakota Arena. Hey, how about a shout out for Bailey Ober? My gosh. Two hits through six innings allowed today and three strikeouts, no walks against Detroit after getting crushed in his opening start against Kansas City. He's been lights out. Twins looking for three out of four in Detroit with a 3-0 lead as they go to the seventh inning. Ready to go here. Teams change ends. 2-0 Minnesota. Goals by Perju and Costa. And Lake Effect controls from the faceoff. Best gets it across to the far side, and now over the line they come. Cievelis lost possession and goes down behind the net. Minnesota in control. It's cleared high off the glass and out to center. Cievelis there. Backhands it rink wide, and Minnesota will get there with Schneider. Trying to reverse it up the wall. Nothing doing there. Now it's centered, and that's picked off by Beldy and goes behind the net. Out of the near side. And loose in the circle. And the Minnesota will clear but not out as Best will hold the zone. He takes a shot. That didn't get through. And now it comes out to center. No, it doesn't either as it's played back by Bogart. I spoke too soon. Back behind the net. And Minnesota controls in the near corner. Now it comes out to center. And it's played back into the Lake Effect zone. Here's a race for it as Perju goes after it. He's got a goal today. And controlled by Morgan. Now loose in the circle as a Minnesota player falls. And back comes Lake Effect down the near wing. Morgan hits the line. Morgan tried to cut in, shoots. And Anderson held the post and made a stop there. Shots in the first period favored Minnesota by a margin of 11-3. And now it's loose to the near boards. Players from both teams crashing in there. Which theoretically they're not supposed to do, but it's hockey after all. Now cleared to the right side, and Schneider tried to clear it ahead, couldn't, and now Lake Effect. Denny works his way in front and can't get a shot away. It's the best shift that Lake Effect has had, I think, as goes back into the left corner. Minnesota will start out. Schneider, a pass to the right, and picked up, and now rink wide. Here they come over the line. Kleinbrook shoots, and that's saved by Carroll. Now a puck picked up by Soule, clears to the right point, held in there. Schneider, left-handed shot, right on, and a save made by Carroll. No rebound, and pushes and shoves there as Marinarczyk with a word there for Kleinbrook as we get a faceoff coming up in the Lake Effect zone to the left of the goal. And from the draw, picked up now by Denny for Lake Effect. Comes ahead. Over the line, shoots, and that's deflected by Machi over the glass and out of play. So the faceoff will come in the Minnesota zone to the left of their goal. 11:51 to go in the second period. And Minnesota ahead 2-0. Now played to center ice, going after it there is Marinarczyk. And he clears up the left wing. So there, banking it ahead, but there's no wing, and Kleinbrook will intercept for Minnesota. Machi, rink-wide pass. Minnesota down the far wing. Grossman over the line, floats it back behind the net. And Cham in the right corner tries to play it ahead. Minnesota has three to the boards there. And now from the wing, a shot by Machi is right on, and a stop by Carroll. 2:44 gone in the second period of the 11s championship. The 12s won by Thieves over Vice Hockey 3-1. Now Minnesota controls from the faceoff, and that is Schneider at the left point. Rink-wide pass to the right. Here's a shot. Save made. Rebound is steered over the top. Great chance for Stinson there. And it might have gone off a defender and high, but they set it up well as Martin took the initial shot. He's got the puck now. Over to the near side with Minnesota back in possession, and now a rink-wide pass to the right from, not Martin, over the line. We're going to get a hit thrown there against Braden Dean. Now a centering pass loose at the left edge, controlled by Lake Effect, cleared around Schneider on the hash mark. Will hold and go behind the net between the feet. Centering pass from Dean is broken up. Now Stinson dropping it back. Schneider at the left point. Returns to Stinson at the top of the circle. Threw it across, looking there for Dean, and he couldn't set him up. Now Dean throwing a hit, and that comes out to center ice. Finally, the puck does, and over the line, McGuire feeds the left. And here's Dennis waiting for some help. Goes to the corner as Martin steers him wide. Now controlled in the right corner. Finally played off the wall, and here's Dennis with it again. Dropping to the left point. Now Best, and that's broken up. Minnesota finally clears, and out to center. Shot in rink wide, and heading back to the bench for Lake Effect Bedoin. They are changing all five. Less than 10 minutes to go in the second period. Minnesota back down the near wing. Dean drops it. Here's Stinson coming up the slot, closing, and lost possession. Backhanded centering pass for Dean, and he comes flying through, but couldn't get any purchase on the puck. And now here comes Lake Effect back, and they are over the line. A shot and a save made by Renner Anderson. We'll get a faceoff with 9:34 now to go in the second period as Savelis broke in on the left, and the goaltender Anderson made the stop. Again, Renner Anderson has allowed, Minnesota has allowed only 5 goals in this tournament this week. And now here, Lake Effect Bogart plays it behind the goal. Minnesota in control there. Shots are 16-4 for Minnesota. Now a centering pass is broken up as Perju broke through and now starts down the far wing. From the red line, he shoots it in. And picked up there by Nash in the corner. Tries to feed to the left point. Played down by Beldy and now controlled finally by Bogart again for Lake Effect. Out to center ice. Morgan over the line. Morgan flips one towards the goal and Anderson with a save, and we'll get a faceoff. 8:54 left in the second period. Minnesota doing a nice, nice job of holding Lake Effect to the perimeter and not letting them get shots through. 16-5, the shot board now reads, as we'll face off to the left of Anderson. From the draw, here's Best shooting, and a stick save by Anderson, no rebound. And a drop right in front of him, and made the save. Now back behind the goal from the faceoff, and here's Martin taken in against the boards by So, and we're going to get a penalty. And or are we? I thought the, yes, we are. And Minnesota will be shorthanded again and again. It's going to be Kleinbrook. And that's a cross check. .524 of the second is the time of that penalty. Two penalties in the game, both against Minnesota. And another power play for Lake Effect as they trail by two. And now Marinarczyk tried to play it across, and I want to, Denny. And now it's picked up, and Machi will play it into the Lake Effect zone. And now here's Costa stealing the puck and heading in. And now we get pushes and shoves exchanged as Best first off had a shove for Costa and then wound up engaged with another Minnesota player. No penalties. Faceoff coming to the right of the Lake Effect goal. Now out to center and it's So. Watched there by Martin. And defeated across. Machi there to pick it up. Nice move to make space for himself as he comes to the right and now starts up. Tried to split the defense and goes down out to center. Stinson claims it for Minnesota. 1:14 remaining in the penalty as Machi back at center now feeds the right and over the line comes Grossman. And then Grossman goes down as he's stopped by Helminen. Back comes So for Lake Effect. Over the line. Driven down to his knees. And now Denny will play it to the near side boards. Now drop pass to the right point, and that's Bodine with a nice play. Bodine centers it. Oh, and had a trigger set up there, and So had to go off the heel of his stick. 40 seconds in the power play. Helminen up the slot. Denny, that's off the defense and wide. Now Anderson dropping it. And again, Bodine feeds the near side for Denny. 27 seconds in the power play. Drops to the right point. Bodine now over to the left. They get to the top of the dots, and the shot winds up going wide. Top of the circle, I should say, as Helminen put it wide. Now Minnesota will pick it up with 14 seconds to go and a long pass. It's a breakaway for Stinson going in on goal. Stinson fires. Oh, he had a great chance there and held it just a little too long and finally couldn't put it up over Carroll, who had fallen. And now back comes Lake Effect. Here's Savelas. He's got a breakaway. Savelas shoots, and he's stopped by Anderson. And we have behind the play another penalty coming as roughing is called on Dean, and that's the third straight penalty on Minnesota. Time of the penalty now is 7 minutes 26 seconds, so they're going to go right back to shorthanded. So another shot for Lake Effect, their third power play of this game. And it's picked up now. Best, high in the slot, shoots, and Anderson with a glove save. First 13 seconds gone in the power play. Near side, Best, closing, shooting. Missed over the top. Long rebound, and Marinarczyk will go back for it. Plays it to the left. Civellis goes down at center ice. Going to get another penalty on Minnesota. Tripping penalty against Rylan Schneider. And that one is going to come at 7:54. So it's going to be 5-on-3 for a minute and a half, and then 5-on-4 for 30 seconds, barring any further penalties. We'll see how they handle this. Now here's Marinarczyk. Comes in front, saved by Anderson. And now a penalty against Lake Effect. A trip. And that came as Schlegel was pulled to the ice, and that will be the first penalty on Lake Effect in this game. And it's Morgan. So that's 8:08. Still a power play, though, for Lake Effect for a minute 19. Just be 4-on-3. And they control from the faceoff. And over the line, falling there was Marinarczyk, and it's loose, finally picked up there by Beldy. Takes it to the corner, 1:05 remaining in the 4-on-3, and Minnesota has possession behind the goal. Bank pass off the wall, and that's going to be cleared all the way down the ice. Deflected, so no icing. Back for it is Perju. He goes down. And now Civellis back for Lake Effect. Over the line with 45 seconds in the power play. Hits the trailer, closes, shoots, save Anderson. Rebound is steered away as Best came in and took his best shot from about 30 feet. Now riding right along the blue line. Minnesota will pick it up and carry to center ice. Over the line, it's Schlegel. He goes wide. Schlegel pushed wide and finally played in against the inboards by Best. Off to the far side, cleared around to an open wing on the near side. Minnesota hoping to hold there, and it's Machi with it. He threw it in front, deflected down by McGuire for Lake Effect. And now with 12 seconds in their power play, it's played out to center, and here's Civellis with it. And a nice play there. Minnesota regains possession of the puck. 4 seconds to go. And up the middle, here's Schlegel from the red line shooting it in as they come back to four aside for about 28 seconds. And then a very quick Minnesota power play coming up of only 10 seconds duration as it comes out to center ice. And now played on into the zone by Best. 15 seconds left in the 4-on-4. As in the corner, it's Martin in control for Minnesota. Plays it to himself off the inboards. 8 seconds to go, and now here they come. Here's Costa over the line. Centers it, and here's a shot right on, and a save made off the shot by Easton Hema. And Minnesota is on the power play now for 10 seconds, and they have an offensive zone faceoff as the penalized players are back on for Minnesota, Dean and Schneider. Faceoff coming up to the right of Caro. And Lake Effect wins the draw. Now picked up there by Costa. Centers it, and a chance for Hema goes begging as the brief power play comes to an end. And the puck is cleared back into the Minnesota zone. And they will gain possession in the left corner with 3:46 to go in the session. Cleared around on the far side. Beldy after it goes back behind for Martin. And Minnesota up the near side. Trying to get out. Lake Effect will hold there along the wall. R.J. Farron. Now, here's Denny trying to thread a pass through. Loose in the slot and finally cleared out to center ice. And Lake Effect will pick it up again. Helminen. Anderson over the line, who I believe I identified as Farron earlier. 24 instead of 34. Now behind the net, here's Beldy. Leaving it in the left corner for Martin. Just over 3 minutes to go in the second period. Martin's outlet pass is picked off, and here's Denny in the slot. Got past one, got past two, centers it, and oh, a nice play by Anderson to slide across and hold the post and keep the puck away. Comes all the way down the ice onto Caro. Renner Anderson's really played well here. He's some good sense. Puck shot all the way down, and going back for it is Schneider with 2:40 to go in the period. And now cleared up the wall on the near side and out to, well, not out, as it's held by Sham. Centering pass, and Lake Effect's Morgan takes it off to the left boards. He centers back for Sham in the high slot, goes beside the net, and Lake Effect trying to find room in front as Civellis could not find an open teammate. Comes out to center ice, and it's controlled there by Sham. Minnesota back in, and here's Schlegel taking it right to the front of the net and then goes down. And Dean behind the goal centers it, and Stinson can't quite reach it. And it comes out to center ice. Minnesota remains in control, and they play it back in, leading 2-0 on two first-period goals from Perju and Costa. Now here is Schneider at the right point, looking to get around Bogart, and does. And Schneider leaves a drop pass from the top of the circle. Here's a shot right on. And Caro makes the stop as Grossman tried to sneak a shot through there. 1:37 to go in the second. From the draw. Minnesota in control, and this is Nash. Oh, nice move to the slot. Scores! Colton Nash. Oh, wow. Nash with a very nice individual effort weaved his way to the top of the left circle as the goalie saw it and then beat him to the far side. And Minnesota expands its lead to 3-0. Colton Nash with the goal. 12:32 of the second period is the time. Now Best plays it in. Off to the far side, Minnesota's Martin. Put it back in front of his net. And now they'll try the near side. Here's Perju. To himself, over the line, goes down. Martin and Perju being given assists. Backhanded shot, Nash scores again. And it's 4-0. And from that angle, a backhanded shot is
kind of showing off. That's didn't have much room for that. And he scores twice in a span of less than half a minute. 12:59 the time, so it's 2 goals and 27 seconds for Colton Nash, and it's 4-0. So breaking in, fires, and a save made by Anderson. Off to the near boards. Less than a minute to go now in the period. A centering pass, and So puts it wide. Now another centering pass. Good chance in front. Let's get the goal. And Gattuso's getting an assist there, too. And now Minnesota again behind the goal. 30 seconds to go. Centering pass loose. And cleared, but not out. And here's a shot and a good stop. In front of the goal is Hema. Took advantage of a turnover and put a good shot on Carroll, who made a smart save with 24 seconds left in the period. Minnesota on top, 4-0. 24 seconds to go in period two. From the draw, Bedoin around on the near side. Beldy's going to hold there, looks to center it. Intercepted and played back behind the goal by Morgan, who can't get past. Beldy from the circle shoots. Carroll saves, rebound controlled by Morgan. Cleared off the wall and finally to center ice with 5 seconds to go in the period. And Minnesota has doubled its pleasure in the second period, scoring twice more. And they lead it 4-0. They had 13 shots in the second period. And Lake Effect at 6, so it's 24-9 after two periods. Quick break in the third next here on the Youth Hockey Hub.
In life, we all need a little help to reach our summit. Whatever your summit looks like, it's easier to reach when your body is strong and healthy. At Summit Orthopedics, our team of highly specialized physicians listens to and values every one of our patients. We take a conservative approach to care to get you back to your healthy and active lifestyle. Reach your summit. Summit Orthopedics. Visit summitortho.com to make an appointment today.
Group of La Tsamatsa Pizza encourages the community pickup hockey game, honors the family that builds the neighborhood-known backyard rink, salutes the passion utilizing a frozen lake to play a game that's loved, endorses the stardom early mindset to build contenders, acknowledges the grit, determination, and competition of the sport, and applauds the coach that demands the before-the-sun-comes-up outdoor practice. Brewpub La Tsamatsa Pizza supports hockey anytime, anywhere.
Third period from Dakota Arena here in Prior Lake as Minnesota leads Lake Effect 4-0 in the U11 finals here at the SDP Invitational 2024. Team's change ends one more time. And Renner Anderson back in goal for Minnesota. Stopped all 9 shots. Gavin Carroll, 20 out of 24 for Lake Effect. 2 goals for Colton Nash in the latter part of that third period. It helped put some space between Minnesota and their competition on the scoreboard as a faceoff comes into their zone to the right. And here's Bogart in the corner. Now playing around behind the net. Siavelis goes in against the boards. Machi leans on him there, kicks it over to the near side. And Bogart lost out. Now Stinson around on the far side, and Dean will control for Minnesota. Carries to the blue line, rink wide to center. Grossman steps inside the defender, now comes into the slot area, takes the shot. Blocker save by Carroll, knocks it over the top of the net. And now controlled by Marinarczyk behind the net. Off to the far side, Machi there along the boards, plays it down, and now here comes Lake Effect back out to center ice. Morgan over the line, having trouble, and there to pick it up is Grossman for Minnesota. And he comes back over the line. Check that, Dean. It leaves a drop pass for Stinson. They come right off him, a centering pass. They try to go back across the face for Dean, and it was deflected before it could get to him. Now loose along the wall on the near side and finally played to the corner. Stinson there. And a sharp-angled shot by Grossman goes off the outside of the goal. Now cleared and out to center. Minnesota will regain possession. Here's Machi.
Rink wides it into the zone. Teams change, 12:25 to go in the game, and Minnesota in command here. The 4-0 lead, a pass comes across to the far side, and Dennis goes after it for Lake Effect. He's taken in against the boards. And after it there, Schneider reversing it, and now controlled by Tuzno. And he plays it ahead. Here's Nash down the wing. Nash with a step, closing in. Nash takes the shot, save made by Carroll. Boy, Nash has really turned it on in the last 10 minutes or so here. And we get a whistle. The puck is behind there. We're going to get a penalty against Lake Effect here with 11:54 to play. We have a roughing penalty coming as Nash was knocked in against the boards. And the time of the penalty, 2:06. And it will go against Lachlan McGuire. This is the first full power play of the game for Minnesota. They had a 10-second power play in the second period, but now they get a full 2 minutes, barring any other infractions, and now Tuzno has it. Comes to the slot, goes beside the net. And they'll work perimeter. And that's Hema. Now Martin feeds it across to the left for Tuzno. Now down, Perju. First 30 seconds gone in the power play. Right on the line, Martin feeds it across to the left. Centering pass comes through Nash on the near side. And Nash threw it across. Tuzno looking to center, comes back behind the net. Perju has it there. And now he leaves it for Nash, gets it back. 1:13 in the power play. And our return pass for Perju is disrupted. Minnesota able to control with Martin. He moves to center point, takes a shot, deflected by Perju wide. And Minnesota works it back to the point, or the sideboards, I should say. And now behind the net, this is Perju. 50 seconds in the power play, 10:45 to play. And here's Martin in the slot, near side, Nash in the circle. Shoot, scores! That's a hat trick, and it is now 5-0 with 10:37 to go. A power play goal for Nash, and that is a natural hat trick. Three straight goals. And it comes at the 3 minute and 23 second mark of the third period. So we'll get the announcement. Minnesota, good patient power play and connects. Now a shot whizzes wide of the goal from Robbie So. Perju and Martin get assists. Now loose in front, and a chance there for Anderson is denied by the other Anderson, Renner, in goal. And with less than 10 minutes to go, it's a 5-goal advantage for Minnesota. And it's over the line and it's offside. And the clock will keep moving as we are into the 5-goal running time rule. 9:43 to go, and Lake Effect trying to first stop the clock. To do that, of course, they would need to score, which has been very difficult for everyone to manage in this tournament against Renner Anderson in Minnesota. Now they start up. And a pass to the line. Hema can't quite reach it, and Lake Effect will pick it up with 9:22 to go. Played out to center ice. Beldy there. And Beldy swings back to the left. And now Schlegel tries to play it ahead and can't. Runs loose to the Minnesota line out of the near side for Easton Hema. Less than 9 minutes to go. Hema centers it. Oh, it bounced free, loose, and Carroll is there to get a glove on it and get a stoppage as we're under 9 minutes now to go.
Now picked up from the faceoff, and Stinson throws it across, and it comes all the way through to the near side. 8.5 minutes to go. And now controlled by Martin. Poked ahead, and Dean will latch on to that. Comes over the line, leaves a drop pass. Stinson can't shoot, got it back, though, and then plays it to the right edge, and Best sears to the corner. That cleared, gets between the point man, and comes all the way down the ice, and that will be an icing call against Lake Effect with 8 minutes left. From the draw, Grossman put it towards the net, now winds up behind. 7:39 to go, and Minnesota on top 5-0. Now an outlet pass picked off, and now out to center. Controlling for Lake Effect as McGuire tries to split two defenders, goes down, and Machi will claim it in the left corner. Plays it back out to center ice. Best rink wide, and then Lake Effect tags up, takes off the offside. Now pass to center ice, intercepted by Sham for Lake Effect. Trying to find space to turn. Lost the puck. Gets some help from his friends. Then loses it again. Machi controlling. Backhanded centering pass deflected onto Carroll by the defenseman, Arnold Sham. And it's stopped for a faceoff. We're under 7 minutes to go. We're in running time here in the third period. 5-0 Minnesota, about to claim the 11s championship at the SDP Invitational, and they have carried all before them so far. Now played around behind the net on the far side, and here is Anderson. Taken in against the boards. Minnesota gets the puck by turnover, cleared around behind the goal, and Nash chasing after it there. He's got three straight goals for Minnesota, the last three goals. And out to center, here comes Lake Effect. Over the line, and Denny is steered in against the boards. And players from both teams in. Right now a four-car pileup as it comes back behind the goal. And that is Schneider rubbed in against the wall. Oh, what a hard hit thrown there. That's going to be a penalty on Alex Denny. And the puck comes in front, and now the penalty will be called with 5:50 to go, but it's going to put a power play in place here for Minnesota. As heading to the penalty box is Robbie So. And we're going to get a second penalty here, as Denny heads to the penalty box. Minor penalty on the board for Denny. Actually, minors both. 9 minutes time of these penalties, both of them. So it's a 5-on-3 power play for Minnesota. Their third. Now up the slot it comes. Here's a shot that goes wide from Zach Martin. So two penalties both on Lake Effect here. They get possession behind the net. Best clears it, and it comes out to center. Beldy there. Over the line. Beldy throws it across. Here's a shot that winds up going off of Carroll and wide of the net. With 4 minutes and 20 seconds to go, Beldy feeds it beside the net. Sharp angled shot right on. Rebound is steered by Hema wide of the goal. Now back to the left point. They work it to the top of the slot. And Kleinbrook puts it wide. Both penalties on Lake Effect were for roughing on So and Alex Denny. 50 seconds left in the power play. Minnesota centers, and it comes through to the near side with less than 4 minutes to play in this game. And now to the high slot. They'll work it around. Here's a shot that's deflected over the top off the stick of Beldy. And now here is Ryland Schneider leaving it. Beldy closing.
shot, and that goes off the defense. Standing monolithic in front of the goal. Now here's a drive, the glove catch made off Kleinbrook by Carroll with 18 seconds in the power play. And by the time they drop the puck again, it should be just about over. 5-0 Minnesota as we come up on 3 minutes to play. Now the penalties are over and Lake Effect back at full strength. Just under 3 minutes left. Now clear to the near side for Bogart. Ahead now to Lachlan McGuire. He goes down. Penalty coming on Minnesota. And there'll be one more chance on the power play for Lake Effect to try to put a goal on the board today. And it'll be Stinson heading to the penalty box. That's a trip. .11:43 the time of the penalty. Fourth power play for Lake Effect. And they immediately have to come back as Minnesota ices the puck. So that will result in a faceoff coming back to the right of the goal as we're under 2 minutes to go. Shots are 29-9 for Minnesota, and they Lake Effect power play wins the faceoff. Here's a shot off Anderson's glove and over the top. Now cleared towards the right point. Morgan. Now McGuire taken in against the boards. Dean there to help out. He goes down. Penalty coming on Lake Effect as he is elbowed in against the boards. And that will take care of the power play. And heading to the penalty box is Bogart. That's a rough. And the faceoff will then come back into the Lake Effect zone. And by the time we do that, we'll have under a minute to go in the period. At 13 minutes and 6 seconds. So we'll finish, hopefully, at 4-on-4. Now a centering pass, and here's a shot deflected off Grossman, or from Grossman and wide. Now played down with 40 seconds to go in the third period. Centering pass as Machi snuck in. And now it's picked up and played on the backhand by Grossman, finally claimed and cleared all the way back by Lake Effect, and that will be an icing call with 23 seconds to go and might be our last action of the game as Minnesota putting the clamps on a convincing and solid 5-0 win. We're down to 12 seconds to go. And they will not drop the puck again. This game is over. And the final score, Minnesota 5 and Lake Effect nothing. They wind up with 29 shots on goal for the game. 11-13-5 by periods. And they held Lake Effect without a shot in the third period. So the final shots are 29-9. And a hat trick for Colton Nash, who is as good as anybody I've seen out here today, certainly. And he winds up with the last three goals of the game. Minnesota are your champions. So we'll listen to the all-tournament team selection and presentation at this time.
from Lake Effect at defense number 28, Finn Elliman. From Minnesota at D, number 5, Luca Machi. From Lake Effect at forward number 8, Alex Denny. From Minnesota at forward number 8, Braden Dean. And also at forward from Minnesota, also our tournament MVP number 98, Colton.
Made in the heart of America's Dairyland, Kekana, Wisconsin. Every brewpub pizza is made with the highest quality meat and veggie toppings. Then bombarded with over half a pound of award-winning Wisconsin mozzarella cheese. Snag a slice of brewpub pizza at the concession stand or enjoy a whole pizza conveniently located in the frozen pizza section of your local grocery store. Brewpub, lots and lots of pizzas, the ingredients for a great time.
Generally speaking, water is a better fluid to use to rehydrate with. A big part of the importance of hydration is hydrating before the race rather than during the race. So, you know, the hydration before a long distance race in particular really starts the day before the race, probably almost 24 to 36 hours before the race to be completely hydrated